Hi, it's Only Light Matters here, and today we have a special video done for summer holidays. I have no time to do a regular one, so we are going to focus on a simple mission. Actually, we are going to make a full rendezvous tutorial to rescue a Kerbal in low Earth orbit. As usual, first, contracts. We are proposed to collect science on the moon. With what we sent last time, I think we won't have to do much effort to collect some. Rescue Kerbals in moon orbit? Yep, we take both of them. A tourist contract? They are usually well paid. We will do it later with a new crewed mission to collect missing surface samples on the moon. Then, technology. We unlock bigger tanks to reduce the number of parts in our rockets. We unlock smaller engines and smaller tanks to make better designs for our ships. Also, we unlock RCS thrusters. They are quite interesting for docking maneuvers and also for rescue missions. Then we unlock the docking claws. I like them because they allow a rescue mission to come back home with the pod which was floating in space. Thus, no debris is left behind. And that would be all for today. Our mission is to rescue Charlas, stranded in low Earth orbit. Hi, Charlas. It won't be long now. Charlas is on a trajectory whose periapsis is at 91 kilometers and whose apoapsis is at 119 kilometers. It means this orbit is just above the atmosphere. As a reminder, in this game, it stops at 89.7 kilometers of altitude. To make a rendezvous, we need to reach a temporary orbit whose periodicity is somewhat different from the vessels we want to join. It has to be significantly shorter or longer. The problem here is that the orbit of Charlas is so low that there is only one valid option in front of us. We have to be higher. Higher means slower. Slower means it's the other ship which will catch us up. So a decision is made to reach a 200 kilometers high orbit. This is our rocket. Pretty simple, a single core is enough to get us to low space. We are now at the very 200 kilometers of altitude we spoke about earlier. As we have a nice view of our ship, let's take this opportunity to talk a bit about it. To make a decent rescue ship, we need an engine. Yeah, could be handy. I picked the Terrier one because it has enough thrust regarding the mass of our craft. It's comfortable enough to maneuver with. We obviously need fuel and enough of it so that it won't be a problem for our training course. We need more fuel because, well, I like when spherical tanks are placed around the nozzle of our main engine. Then we need a pod with a capacity for a crew of two. We need RCS thrusters for precise maneuvers when we will be close enough to the ship we are going to rescue. Monopropellant tanks? If not, all RCS thrusters will be useless. Batteries to get enough power in the shadow of the Earth. Solar panels to recharge all batteries. Reaction wheels to have a better control of the orientation of our craft. A docking claw to dock to any part. Thus, we are going to perform our first docking maneuver in this game. Lights to see what we do when in the shadow of the Earth. shoots to avoid a little braking maneuver, a license plate because, well, our ship needs to be registered. By the way, thanks, Jeps, for managing the paperwork with the administration. And a special device because we won't stop for red lights here. We are a rescue team after all. After having circularized at 200 kilometers of altitude, the next step is to align the planes of both orbits. As a disclaimer, I prefer to say no that all the maneuvers you are going to see are absolutely not optimal. The purpose is to show that any people can make a rendezvous with basic piloting skills, and precision is absolutely not required to grant success. Make sure you have selected the target ship. Ascending node and descending node appear. The UI also shows the angle, which is 5 degrees. We choose to plan a maneuver as soon as possible, thus at the next descending node. If we right-click on this one, the inclination remains displayed. We can now control what it will be given the amount of delta V spent. When we reach zero, we are done. We time warp and we execute the node. Now we have to plan another maneuver to get close to the ship we target. It's the first part of a Hammond transfer. We also want the separation distance between us and our target to be the lowest. To do this, we need to plan a retrograde burn. Again, we play a bit with the controls. We can adjust the granularity of the maneuver tool and use the forward or rewind controls to adjust the exact time the maneuver will have to be done. We also use the prograde and retrograde controls to adjust the delta V spent. After a few minutes playing with the node, we get a separation of 2.3 kilometers. It's not perfect, but more than enough for this tutorial. As the two ships are initially very distant to each other, we will have to wait for several orbits before executing this maneuver. Our ship node gently loses altitude while going towards the intersect point. Notice that at this encounter point we will have a velocity greater than our targets, and the difference is 96 meters per second. Next step, we need to perform another maneuver so that our velocity matches our targets. As soon as I see we have reached the 2.5 distance we spoke about earlier, I ignite our engine. This maneuver is always a retrograde burn with the SAS in target mode, and we reduce the difference of the velocity to zero. We are now on a very close orbit to our targets. Still, we are more than 2 kilometers away. While this is very simple, we align our ship with the target marker on the navbar and we accelerate in this direction. I recommend not to exceed a 10 meters per second relative velocity. While getting close, you can notice the target marker on the navbar slightly moves away. We need to narrow our course, or we will miss our target. It is now that we are going to reap the benefits of the all-powerful Navball. First, switch to retrograde, always in target mode. The retrograde marker of our ship and the retrograde marker of our target are not aligned. That means our velocity vectors differ by a few degrees. We need to align them. Second, move away the center of the navball in the opposite direction of the marker of our target. Third, give a little push with your engine and see how the magic operates. If not enough, you can repeat the process. We are now close enough, and we have a very small relative velocity. From this point, we won't use our main engine anymore. We switch back to prograde and we activate the RCS thrusters for all remaining operations. We can control the translation of our ship in any direction. We can also press the caps lock key to activate the precise maneuver mode. What we do is to keep both markers aligned to ensure we are on a collision course with our target. Under 50 meters of separation, lower your speed to avoid any accident. The last meters should be covered with a maximum of 1 meter per second velocity. In this configuration, you will dock without any problem. Oh my gosh! I forgot to arm the crew. Well, what would a Brylon victory be without any difficulty, So, don't forget to arm the crew. That's a key milestone for an outstanding result. Okay, we arm the crew and we redo our approach. I realign the markers and I move forward because the target is now actually moving away. And we have docked! Haha, you see? Not that difficult. As a matter of fact, we don't see the other curveball popping up in our crew area. I have to right-click on the rescued pod to manually do a crew transfer. Because a direct transfer is not that roleplay with the crew, Shellas make a short EVA to join Jib. The rescue mission is almost finished. Let's get back on dry land. This tutorial now comes to an end. Next time we will rescue two kerbals around the moon, and maybe we will be able to do both in a single mission. Take care, and don't forget to test your startup.